Hello everyone, welcome back. So in today's lecture, we are going to discuss about the dimensions of flywheel. So how we can calculate the dimensions of rim of flywheel, like cross sectional area and diameter of flywheel rim. So as we know that the inertia of flywheel is provided by the hub, spokes, and as well as from rim. But inertia due to hub and spokes is very small, so usually it is ignored. But in case it is known, it can be taken into account. So let's consider one rim of flywheel whose mean radius is r. So mean radius is given by r, and thickness of the rim is taken as t. And now we can consider a element over the rim of the flywheel, and we are considering this element over the rim of the flywheel, and this element makes an angle at the center of flywheel rim by d theta. So this is angle, and we are taking this element at the theta angle from horizontal axis. So this angle is theta. So now let's consider some parameter. So let omega is the angular velocity, and r is the mean radius, and t is the thickness of rim. And rho is the density of material of the rim. Rho is density of material of rim. So if we are considering this element, and if this rim is rotating with omega velocity, then this element will experience a centrifugal force in radially outward direction. So this will experience a centrifugal force Fc in radially outward direction. So to find out the centrifugal force, we must know the mass of this element, mean radius already we know r, and we know the omega. So Fc is equal to mr omega square. We can find out the centrifugal force which is experienced by this element. So now the centrifugal force on the element, we can write the centrifugal force on this element per unit length. So here per unit length means we are considering the length of this rim which is perpendicular to the screen is unit. Or if I draw the cross sectional area of this rim, let's say this is the cross sectional area of this rim, so we can say this is the thickness of rim, this is equal to t, and this dimension or width of the rim or length of the rim perpendicular to this screen is we are considering right now, which is equal to unit. So we can say the centrifugal force on this element per unit length is considered, or that will be equal to mr omega square. So first of all, we have to find out the mass of this element. So mass of this element, so mass is equal to volume multiplied by density, and volume can be found out using the cross sectional area multiplied by length multiplied by density. So this would be the mass of this element. So cross sectional area, as we know that from this cross sectional area we can find out t multiplied by 1. So this is t multiplied by 1, and length of this element can be find out using, so this is the length of this element, and that would be r multiplied by d theta. So that would be r multiplied by d theta, and density is equal to rho. So this is mass of this element, or we can write this as dm, right? So the centrifugal force per unit length is mr omega square. So m already we have find out, which is given by rho r multiplied by t multiplied by d theta, and this is m, now r, now omega square. So this becomes rho r square multiplied by t multiplied by omega square multiplied by d theta. So now we know that this force is in the radially outward direction. So now we can find out the force in the vertical direction as well as in the horizontal direction. So we can resolve this force Fc into two component, one in the horizontal direction, that would be Fc. If this angle is theta, then this angle will also theta. So Fc cos theta, and one component of this force in the vertical direction, that would be Fc sin theta. So now we can say the force, centrifugal force on this element per unit length in the vertical direction, centrifugal force on this considered element per unit length in vertical direction, or centrifugal force in vertical direction on this element per unit length, that would be rho r square t omega square d theta and sine component of this force. Now to find out the total force experienced by this element or this rim in the vertical direction, so now we can find out the total force from theta is equal to 0 to theta is equal to 180 degree. We can integrate this Fc sin theta from 0 to 180 to find out the total force on the rim in the vertical upward direction. So now we can integrate this force in the vertical direction. So we can say the total vertical force per unit length is equal to 0 to pi rho r square t omega square d theta to sine theta, and we can write this as rho r square t omega square 0 to pi sine theta d theta. So if we solve this, this will be equal to rho r square t omega square minus cos theta 0 to pi, or that becomes 2 times of rho r square t omega square. So this is the total force in vertical direction, total force in vertical direction per unit length. What does it mean? This means that if we cut this rim from horizontal axis, or if we draw the sectional view of this rim along this axis, if we cut it from here, then this becomes, I can draw the cut section something like this. So that would be right? So total force in vertical direction is equal to 2 rho r square t omega square, and horizontal component of these forces will be cancelled out because the same force will be acting in the this direction if I resolve and integrate from 0 to pi, and I'll get the same component from here to here if I'll integrate from 0 to pi by 2, then there would be a component of horizontal force and same component will be in this direction. So that will be cancelled out, and because of the similarity, we'll get the same force in this direction, in the vertical downward direction, if I'll consider an element over here, and if I integrate this from pi to 2 pi, then I'll get the same component of force, that would be 2 rho r square t omega square. So because of this force, there would be a stresses at this place, sigma and sigma. So so this stress will resist, or will develop the resisting force, or we can say because of the resisting force, these stresses or circumferential stresses will be developed. If I draw the cross-sectional area over here, then that would be something like this, and this direction is t, and we considered the length of this hub perpendicular to this screen, that is unit. So area of this is equal to t multiplied by 1, and same area will be here at this place, t multiplied by 1. So total area multiplied by sigma, that would be equal to this force. So now we can consider, let sigma is the circumferential stress induced in the rim, So circumferential stress, also we call this as a hoop stress, right? So now for the equilibrium, stress multiplied by area will give us the resisting force, and that should be equal to this centrifugal force. So total area t multiplied by 1 from this place and t multiplied by 1 from this place. So we can say 2 multiplied by t multiplied by 1 multiplied by sigma, that must be equal to this force, and that is 2 rho r square t multiplied by omega square. So this 2 will get cancelled out, t will also get cancelled out, and sigma equals to rho r square omega square. And from here, as we know that v equals to r omega, so v is the tangential velocity. If this is the omega velocity, then at the mean radius, if we find out the tangential velocity v, that would be equal to r omega square. So we can replace r omega by v. So sigma is equal to rho v square. So this is the relationship between induced hoop stress and tangential velocity of this rim. So now this relationship between hoop stress and tangential velocity will provide the limit over the tangential velocity. We can use this to find out the limiting tangential velocity. Right? So now this sigma cannot exceed the material property. So sigma permissible will be provided to us according to, based on the material of the rim, right? So because of the rotation of the flywheel, that sigma should not surpass the permissible velocity. So using this relationship, we can find out the limiting velocity. And as we know that the tangential velocity can be given by this formula, v equals to pi dn by 60, right? Meter per second. So here n equals to, in RPM, rotation per minute speed, and d is the mean diameter of the flywheel. So from this relationship we can find out the limiting velocity, and by putting that limiting velocity at this place we can find out the mean diameter of the rim, right? Mean diameter in meter. So this is the mean diameter of rim. So by using this relationship we can find out the mean diameter of rim, right? As we know that the mass of the rim, mass of rim can be find out using, that is m. So mass is equal to density multiplied by volume. And volume can be find out using the cross sectional area and multiplied by length. So as we know that the cross sectional area of this rim is t multiplied by length of this rim. So if we consider the length of this rim as equal to b, right? So length of this rim, thickness is t, and length perpendicular to this screen is, let's say this is b. So cross sectional area is t multiplied by b, and total length of this rim is equal to circumference of this rim, and circumference is pi d, right? So we can use this relationship over here. So the density is rho, so m equals to rho, and cross sectional area is t multiplied by b, and length is pi multiplied by d. So m equals to rho pi d b multiplied by t. So using this relationship we can find out the cross sectional area using this equation. We can find out the cross sectional area, or you can say b and t of the rim. So this is how we can find out the dimensions of flywheel ring. So thank you.